Well, last week we found out that the 1973 abortion case, Roe v. Wade, which effectively allowed abortion anywhere, anytime in the US, may be overturned, and that the decision-making process would go back to individual states. So California, New York, and other Democrat-led states would become dangerous ground for the unborn child and the pregnant woman, while Republican-led areas like Texas, Florida, Mississippi would respect all human rights and would protect the most vulnerable, the unborn child. Now, abortion activists are enraged that their right to kill the unborn child could be impacted. But it's been amusing to watch the pro-abortion and radical left trip over themselves in their spin. And here's a couple of examples. So President Joe Biden is furious that the Supreme Court might make a decision in this area. Although he wasn't furious with them when they legalized gay marriage back in 2015. Funny that. And the current abortion law is by Supreme Court judges. Roe v. Wade is by Supreme Court judges, and he likes the decision, so he likes the court making the decision, no problem. But this possible new law is by Supreme Court judges also, but he doesn't like the decision. He says it goes way overboard, and so he says the Supreme Court shouldn't be making it. Well, that's known as hypocrisy. But during his comments, he makes this admission. He says, quote, "No one can make the judgment to abort a child." Abort a child? Not a fetus, not a blob of tissue, not just about the woman's body because there's two bodies involved. This is about the right to kill a child, the death penalty. Have a watch.
The idea that we're going to make a judgment that is going to say that no one can make the judgment to choose to abort a child based on a decision by the Supreme Court, I think goes way overboard.
Oops. Yeah. Okay. And then there's California and the governor there, Gavin Newsom, who wants California to be a sanctuary for abortion if Roe v. Wade gets overturned. Come to California. We'll kill your unborn child. As pro-life activist Lila Rose says, a sanctuary where children are taken to be killed? More like a slaughterhouse than a sanctuary. Horrific. But it was this tweet where Gavin Newsom tripped himself up. He said, "If men could get pregnant, this wouldn't even be a conversation. This decision isn't about strengthening families, it's about extremism. It's about control. We will fight for the right to choose." If men could get pregnant? What a transphobe Newsom is. Men can get pregnant, according to the left, according to gender ideology. But as Newsom was spinning his yarn, he just tripped up. If men could get pregnant. He is so bigoted. And there's another classic thing. Generally, men are told, if you don't have a uterus, which they don't, biology 101, although don't tell that to gender activists. If you don't have a uterus, men, you can't comment on abortion. But have you noticed who have commented already? Biden, a man. Newsom, a man. In fact, here's a photo of the Supreme Court justices who decided Roe v. Wade in 1973 in favor of abortion. Yep, 9 mostly white men. Men. It was a great decision, apparently. According to the left, we love men when they make decisions we like. They can talk on abortion when they support abortion. See the hypocrisy of the left? Somebody said if they didn't have double standards, they'd have no standards at all. There was great comments from the previous Vice President Mike Pence, who served under President Trump last week, and he was pushing back. The comments were last week, not the president. He was pushing back on the current Vice President Kamala Harris, who she says she's concerned for women, but not for unborn women, not for the unborn little girl.
In 13 of those states, women would lose access to abortion immediately and outright. Those Republican leaders who are trying to weaponize the use of the law against women, well, we say, how dare they? How dare they tell a woman what she can do and cannot do with her own body? How dare they?
And then last night, we heard former Vice President Mike Pence say, I say with the lives of 62 million unborn boys and girls ended in abortion since 1973, generations of mothers enduring heartbreaking and loss that can last a lifetime. Madam Vice President, how dare you?
Yep, and those are great comments from Mike Pence. Now, finally, you may have heard of comedian Dave Chappelle on Netflix. He got in trouble last year for challenging the gender ideology. He said that every human being needed a woman to be born, which is true. But anyway, he did recently a two-minute spiel on abortion. Now, watch these two clips. I won't show you the whole clip because of some of the foul language, but he never reveals whether he's for abortion or against abortion, but what he does do is expose the flawed logic of the left. Have a look.
I'm not for it, but I'm not against it either. It all depends on who I get pregnant.
Yep, everyone laughs, whether they're pro or anti-abortion, because he just sounds downright selfish. Surely abortions shouldn't be decided like that. Well, and then he makes this interesting comparison. He talks about the woman's right to choose, but watch what he goes on to next.
I believe they have the right to choose. I believe that they shouldn't have to consult anybody except for a physician about how they exercise that right. Gentlemen, that is fair. And ladies, to be fair to us, I also believe if you decide to have the baby, a man should not have to pay. It's my money, my choice. And if I'm wrong, then perhaps we're wrong.
It's a very clever statement, isn't it? My money, my choice. If you have the right to kill the unborn child, I have the right to abandon the unborn child. And he says, and if I'm wrong, which of course he is, then perhaps we're wrong. And of course, pro-abortion supporters are wrong. You don't have the right to kill the unborn child, and you don't have the right to abandon the unborn child. Chappelle very cleverly exposes the hypocrisy of the pro-abortion argument, even without us knowing for sure where he stands on the issue. Let me just close this episode with that quote again from my colleague in Florida. He said this, we need to show that we can create a world where we can love children and not kill them. That we can create a world where adoption is always the best option, better option. That we can create a world where we care for both women and their children. This is our opportunity to now make the grisly practice of abortion, like slavery, unthinkable in a civilized, modern society. You know, unthinkable, it's a great word. And it's got to be unthinkable for the sake of the unborn child.